Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how to get the essential site information for your architecture projects. All right, so I've imported this geolocated site. It has the terrain. We are showing that. I have another video that shows you how to get this. So you can click that in the description below to go check this out. But what I don't have here, I do have the terrain and it is rough, but what I don't have is the property line. Now I'm going to say that you shouldn't be using the site information in here, the terrain and the how I'm going to teach you how to use the property line. This is like super rough. So if you're looking for a proposal for a job, so you want to do like a quick design for that, it's appropriate for that. Or if the client is in the process of obtaining a survey and you just want to do some quick work at the beginning to sort of figure out like maybe there's some extra stuff that you want the surveyor to get. Maybe that makes sense in that case. But don't ever use your own services as a way to justify not having a survey because it'll bite you in the butt later on. So that's just, I want to make that very clear. Always get a survey from the owner if you're doing an architectural project. So there's that. Now, what I'm going to show you is actually, if I wanted the property information, I wouldn't know necessarily how to get that. But if I go look for an assessment map, essentially what that is the tax information for property. So the way that this county works is that they have this online version of all the assessment for this area. And depending on where you live, this may or may not exist. You can go to the city and ask for an assessment map, and they should have one there. But this is online, so it makes it super easy. But what it allows me to do is actually come in here and measure this back property line of the site. So what I can do is take this line and measure it all the way over here. So you can see that that is, let's say, 1,445.3 feet. Okay, so that's that. Now what I could do to get the property line here is zoom out a little bit. I want to make sure I can grab this whole thing. Okay, so I'm just going to grab a screen cap here of this. I'm using Sketch, which integrates with Evernote. I'm going to save this. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to import that image that I just saved. It's on the desktop. I saved it as Sketch. So I'm going to import this as an image because I want it to be in a physical space, and then it wants me to scale it. So I'm just going to scale that roughly. I'm going to draw a line that goes over this orange line, which is my property. This just makes it a little bit easier that I can check to make sure it's only on one plane, on that face plane. I'm going to select both of these, group them. This just makes it so that I'm not scaling my entire model. I'm going to click into this group, hit T for the tape measure tool, measure this, click there so you can see it's 824 feet, 3 15/16 of an inch. I'm going to select that, and then what I had measured in the assessment program was 1,445.3, and don't forget your feet or whatever measurement you're using, because it'll default. So like this, if I typed in 1,445.3, it would say inches instead of feet. So you just want to make sure that that is the correct increment. I do want to resize the active grouper component. Yes, because I'm in the active grouper component and I don't want to scale this, even though it's locked. So we have that. Now it's the same size. So what I want to do here is type parallel projection, standard views. And basically what I want to do is overlay my property line on top of this terrain. But you can see that if I move this, it's cutting through the terrain. So I want to move that. I'm going to press the up arrow to move that in the vertical direction to make sure that it's above. Go to standard view's top again. Now when I move this, it covers it. So what you need to do is open your tray. If you don't have this, go to window default tray. This will say show tray, and make sure that you have materials checked, and that'll show up here. What I want to do is select this image, go to edit. So I just choose the eyedropper tool and selected that image that I imported, go to edit, change the opacity to whatever helps you be able to see through that, and then reposition it so that it's roughly about what you had before. Now it's not going to match perfectly. And there's a few different reasons for that. The satellite could be at a different angle. It could be slightly out of scale. But like I said, this is rough, so it should be fine for what you're using. And at least if you have the correct property size, then you can shift it when you get the survey. So then you would trace the property line here. This is good because it's not just a box. Is giving me some good information, some parallel lines, perpendicular lines. There we go. I'm gonna come all the way up to here. Okay, so now we have this shape, and you can get rid of this. I'm gonna hide it just for now. So I have this shape. I'm gonna unlock this, explode it for now, because I have that 2D terrain. I'm gonna select this, make it a group, and then I'm going to select drape. You can also go to there's a draw sandbox, there's two of them, tool, sandbox, drape, or stamp. I'm going to choose drape over that, and you can see now that in three dimensions, I didn't grab enough of the site here, but I have that shape. I have a line on here that designates where the property is. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.